everybody. Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop here, and welcome to the third video on this channel. I don't really know why I count, but I guess it's pretty early on, so we might as well. Today we're back in Gold Coast Aquarium, and right off the bat, I think you can see a few things have changed. We'll zoom out, actually, to look at the whole thing, because I haven't really built much over in this area where you're overlooking the bay, but it is a pretty cloudy day, just because, you know, sometimes in this part of California it does rain pretty heavily. So I thought I'd turn it to the setting just for some little bit of authenticity. But yeah, we do have, I think this bay was here in the last episode, but I did expand it and added a lot of pine trees in the back, just so you can't see the rolling hills this time, but I usually do let them exist, you know. And all of the new stuff is back here, but I figured we'd start at the entrance because why not? So we come back through here. Nothing has changed, of course. I still have yet to figure out what to do here. I might add a gift shop. That's what somebody suggested. You can come through here, get your coffee. But all of the new stuff is out here. Yes. So right off the bat, this little plaza area is based on the Nepenthe restaurant in Big Sur, California. It overlooks the ocean, but this part is just the elevator building that leads into the main aquarium. If you want, you can sit over here, and there's some pillows that are made of the Indian sacks. And yeah, there's a lot of gardening over here. Shout out to Lord Duck Tapington for all of these awesome desert plants. This one especially is my personal favorite. I use it everywhere lately, just because it looks so good. Finally, someone figured out how to use the poya plants for something, because they were very bright green before, but when you turn them upside down, they get a nice sort of darker, warmer tone that works better with the colors in this area. So we'll come up through here. There's a little staff door in here that leads into the axolotl tank, which is our first proper exhibit with living animals. How I figured this would work, we'll go back around. This is just a cube, but it's supposed to be like leading into here. And I guess there would be like a little staircase that would open up here. I just put in a door, but I guess there'd be a window for a staff member to maybe come fetch them if they needed them, or if they needed any sort of like medical attention. And the water wouldn't like spill into this part of the building. And I used a bunch of logs and pots for them to rest in. You know, they don't exist, but a technique I used was putting the little glass panel instead of water, because the water can sometimes be really finicky with small tanks like this, and I think it does the job about as well. And the sort of deserty themes, just because axolotls are actually found in Mexico, but I thought it'd be fun to have them here just for like a little starting exhibit. And then we copied our sign over into this room, but we just recolored it, and then we have this map. I forget who that's by. We can actually find out. I just discovered you can look up people's items on the workshop. It's a great map. It is by Bork. This is Bork's map. Really well done. I just removed the frame and put it on this Asian sign, and I think it works really well as sort of a more effective border. And then this elevator, let's also look at who that's by. I'm not even sure if this will show up on OBS, but we'll find out. Either way, I'm narrating. So this is Tove's workshop elevator. Okay, so yeah, you come up through here. I like the little arrow signs with the water droplets. I don't know if we'd need these anymore with all of the new pieces we have, but I think it's kind of a fun touch. And I didn't do an interior for the elevator, obviously, so we're just going to go up through here. And yeah, this is the first exhibit. Well, I mean, the axolotl was the first, but this is the first big exhibit in Gold Coast Aquarium, which is the Haribo Jelly Center. And we're actually going to turn on sun, because I think it looks much better in the sunlight. Just fast forward there. Da-da-da. Beautiful. Yeah, so this is the Jelly Cellar. but first, this is Bongo Hardwood's clownfish sort of mural, and I just sort of shoved in the elevator door and put it like that, so it's sort of a mural that was sort of painted over when the elevator was installed. And then, so yeah, this is the Haribo Jelly Center. out front. I really love how this came out, this sort of barrel cactus garden. I think it's kind of like thematically appropriate given how, I guess they kind of look like jellyfish. This sort of round shape language, all along with the stones, which are actually, I'll show you. There's just the Japanese macaque statues, and I sunk them into the ground just because I think they work really well as sort of a rounded, polished garden stone that you'd see in a garden like this. And then over here, I sunk in the temple bricks and just recolored them to be more terracotta. And then I put in all of these like little plants that would be growing out if they weren't like sort of left unattended. So we got like the nettles, the cowberry, the triode grass. And I thought it looked kind of like abandoned, but I think it's sort of a very nice rustic touch. I feel like they wouldn't really bother with this if it wasn't really impeding guests' travel or guest foot traffic. And we'll actually go over here because there's really nothing on this side besides decoration, but we have sort of a vineyard using the, what are these called? The Alpine Courant and the, what are these flowers called? That I don't know. Come here. Whatever. They're purple flowers, but I learned this technique from Haribo in his Missoula Zoo project, which is, I had actually built this, what is going on? There we go. I'd actually built this winery exterior. Well, it's not a winery, it's a wine cellar. But I built this exterior before I knew what Missoula Zoo was. But once Haribo released that, it like blew this out of the water. So I had no choice but to reference like some of it. This exterior is based on the Blue Sky Cellar in California Adventure at Disneyland. It's not one-to-one, but the entrance sign and the sort of big side windows, which are made of the Arctic doors in-game, it's like 95% based on it. And we have the ironwood bush. I think it works as a sort of lavender, which you see in a lot of like Italian-style gardens. And the entrance on the other side is the exact same, but I have yet to decorate it. Hello there, Mr. Archer. And yeah, and then this thing, I guess it's just a shade structure. It looks like you would grow something on it, but I didn't see any pictures of stuff growing on it from the reference, which is the Mill Valley Lumber Yard in Mill Valley, California, where I just was actually, but I'm back in Long Beach now. And I just thought it looked really cool and rustic, and I needed a kind of space filler here, so I just built it and threw it down, and there's string lights at the top, and I just think it looks like a super adorable rustic facade. So we will now go into the jelly cellar. More duct taping thin plants. And there's a, what is this thing called? A yellow cedar in a pot, which I also learned from Haribo. You just take the round bead and put some of the other beads around it, and it makes a really nice wooden pot. So we'll actually turn on night because there is lighting in the jelly cellar. In terms of how I came up with this, so I built the wine cellar, and then I was like, what would be a good fit in here besides like wine? And I just thought the same sound with the jelly in the jelly cellar. I was like, oh, jellyfish, perfect. So yeah, it was kind of a challenge to make it work. I think it's a really weird choice of theming, but I don't know. You guys let me know how it goes. Oh, and also, credit to Leaf. Because Leaf suggested a jellyfish tunnel room, but I'm not very good at making those underwater tunnels, but Pawsley did just put out a great new video about making like super clean, easy ones. So I might exploit that in the future, but let's go inside. And this is the jelly cellar. Right off the bat, props to Jess Goron for these barrels. He used them in his Beaks of Bergen project for his Red Panda exhibit, but I just think they make absolutely phenomenal looking normal barrels. And these jellyfish, they were in somebody's aquatic pack. Let's look at that, because I now know how to look at people's stuff right off the bat, which is super helpful. I think it's marine. No? Oh, that's my stuff. Hold on. Real professional, real smooth, marine, aquatic, no, whatever, I'll link it, perfect, yeah, that was real smooth, so yeah, this is the jelly cellar, it's like a sort of repurposed traditional wine cellar, so there's like the cross-hatched placement of the bottles, And then for the larger ones, they're sort of leaned over to this. This is also a Haribo technique. I stole a lot from Haribo. I didn't use any of the stuff he built, but a lot of his techniques are in here. And these are just the brace anchors with some lights. These like Australian circle lights for the labels. They're very janky, but from a distance, I think they look perfect. And in here, I just took Goron's barrels and scraped out the middle part and put in some glass. And I have these gutter pipe kind of moon jellies. I think they look really cute and also sort of convincing from far away. And it's just copied over on this side. And then we have these larger tanks for larger jellies. And then this thing took, I don't know, like an hour, but it took a long time. It's just the gutter pipes. How many optics? 3,000. Yeah. I'm glad this isn't going to be like a huge project. Otherwise, the lag would be unbearable in the future. But yeah, these are just the gutter pipes sunk into the wall. And this this specific wine cellar is directly based on an image when I just looked up wine cellar. And yeah, it's a pretty simple build, but I do think it's, I love how it came out. I love these little tasting tables. And this is another barrel that I based on one of Haribo's because I just needed a larger barrel to sort of juxtapose the smaller ones. And yeah, there's a bigger jelly in here. And I figured the zookeepers would just come and flip open the top if they needed to do any sort of maintenance. And there would be like piping, filtering all the water throughout the building. I actually did add like a cylinder pipe for the ones on the wall, but I figured the pipes in the center would be hidden by the other barrels. But yeah, that's pretty much it. This was going to be a quick one, I figured, but this took me quite some time just because it's a very detailed, very small build. And I will actually turn on daytime because it doesn't look half as good, but I would like to show you guys some of the detail I did for the wine cellar. Oh wait, that's actually cool. I like how the, if you turn it to like early morning, for some reason, whoa, I'm like making a discovery here, but this looks really cool when it's like early morning and it's like somewhat lit, but not all the way. But yeah, here's all the detail in the wine cellar. It's just the traditional beams and planks, and then I put these, what are these called? The fence copper pillars that are recolorable. I just put those in between each section, and I think it adds a lot of really nice texture. And then I put the simple wooden floor in the at the bottom. And up top, it's kind of a, how would you say, sort of rounded top, sort of like it's in a tunnel, because almost all wine cellars are like this, at least the older ones, where they're either underground or in the basement, so there's sort of like a carved out sort of rounded ceiling. And these are just the South American pillars. And then what else? Oh yeah, this thing, it's sort of like a big coral decoration that I just made out of the branches. I've been finding a lot of use for these branches. They make for like really nice either decorations or wall decals. I recommend you guys check those out. And yeah, that is pretty much it. It actually looks really good in the early morning. I'll have to send a few screenshots to Bronation. And yeah, Archer welcoming us back. And then one more thing to show you guys. Damn, this map is really pretty in the early morning. I did not notice this. Let's check it out from the entrance. I don't know why it's being so laggy, but yeah, wow, okay. I have to take more screenshots at this hour. I feel like people would really like this, because this is gorgeous, especially with the pine trees being lit from behind. But I will turn it back today just so we can see this building better. This is the actual winery. This is the winery building, which obviously isn't finished, but there's going to be like a huge tiled plaza. And I guess it'll function as the zoo's primary restaurant, or not zoo, aquarium. Aquarium's primary restaurant. And it'll be overlooking all this, and it'll be super pretty. And I'm not really sure where we're gonna, like, how we're gonna expand, but odds are it'll be as pretty as this. I bet with the larger aquarium buildings, we'll have a lot of fun with the interior. More so than the exterior, because most aquariums don't really bother unless it's a smaller building. But yeah, I'm really excited to see how this project turns out. Thanks again, Leaf, for recommending a jellyfish room. I sort of put my own spin on it, but I think the suggestion stayed more or less. And yeah, we'll finish this, and I think we'll definitely put in a new exhibit. I like to have a new exhibit every episode, just to, you know, for the sake of content. I don't just want to show you guys like the restaurant and then leave, but yeah, expect a new exhibit. We have like this list, I guess, to keep me on track of stuff we could put in. Maybe sea lions. I guess sea lions would be fun by the entrance, but maybe a freshwater aquarium that we could do like a sort of foresty trail for. Either way, leave suggestions, because I think the series, I want the series to be based on people's suggestions. And yeah, that is pretty much it, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I have Daler Zoo back, the map, so expect a tour of that, even though Pawsley already did one, and if you haven't checked that out, you definitely should, but Pawsley did a tour of Daler Zoo, but I'll do my own, just because I built it and I have some extra trivia. And yeah, a few other videos planned are touring all my franchise zoos, and I have like a list, but you know, I'll let you guys know when they happen. So, of course, thanks for watching, and goodbye.